Samsara Sagare Magnam.
Samsara Sagare Magnam.
Deenam Maam.
Deenam Maam.
Karunanidhe.
Karunanidhe.
Karma Moha.
Karma Moha.
Grihitangam.
Grihitangam.
Maam Uddhara.
Maam Uddhara.
Bhavarnavat.
Bhavarnavat.
Shrimat.
Srimad
Bhagavatakshoyam
Bhagavatakshoyam
Pratyaksha
Pratyaksha
Krishna Evahi
Krishna Evahi
Svikritosi
Svikritosi
Mayanatha
Mayanatha
Muktyartham
Muktyartham
Bhavasagare
Bhavasagare
Manoratho
Manoratho
Madiyoyam
Madiyoyam
Safala
Safala
Sarvathatvaya
Sarvathatvaya
Nirvignenaiva
Nirvignenaiva
Kartavyo
Kartavyo
Dasoham
Dasoham
Tavakeshava
Tavakeshava
Shukarupa
Shukarupa
Prabodhagnya
Prabodhagnya
Sarvashastra
Sarvashastra
Visharada
Visharada
Etatkatha
Etatkatha
Prakashena
Prakashena
Madagnyanam
Madagnyanam
Vinashaya
Vinashaya
Vande
Vande
Nandavrajastrinam
Nandavrajastrinam
Padarenum
Padarenum
Abhikshnashaha
Abhikshnashaha
Yasam
Yasam
Harikathodgitam
Harikathodgitam
Punati
Punati
Bhuvanatrayam
Bhuvanatrayam
Vande
Vande
Nandavrajastrinam
Nandavrajastrinam
Padarenum
Padarenum
Abhikshnashaha
Abhikshnashaha
Yasam
Yasam
Harikathodgitam
Harikathodgitam
Punati
Punati
Bhuvanatrayam
Bhuvanatrayam
Interpretation which says that the Lord was trying a long distance call. Please clap for them. They're magicians. They create all the sounds that you want. Simulation. So he's dialing whom? Lord Shiva, Kapaleshwara. Hello Shiva. Shiva says, hello Krishna. I'm in a problem, great problem. And Shiva says, you in a problem? Artha, Vishnu, Shidilatya, Bita. What problem do you have? Big problem, sir. I have never tasted poison. You have drunk gallons of poison. You know how to drink poison. How should you drink poison? Shiva says, shut your eyes and drink poison. It won't be bitter at all. That's what every mother says to the child. Now shut your eyes and drink. That is how the Lord is about to drink poison. This woman who came to kill is going to be liberated. She takes the Lord in her hands and begins to breastfeed him. He begins to feed upon her life, says the Bhagavata. Tasmintanam durjarya viryamulbanam ghorankamadaya shishodadavata gadam karabhyam bhagavan prapidyatat pranay samam rosha samanvito apivat. He began to drink upon her life and she said, leave me. Muncha. Muncha means leave. Muncha, strangely, is the verb for moksha also. The first muncha is physically leave me, give me peace, give me freedom from pain. First muncha is physical freedom. The second muncha is release me from the world. Narayana, punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani, jatare shayanam. You are not the child of Vasudeva or Devaki. You are not brought up by Nan Baba and Yashoda. You are Narayana Purushottama. I don't want to go back to Kamsa. Release me from the cycle of birth and death, Narayana. Muncha, muncha, alamiti prabhashini, nishpidyamana, akhila jeeva marmani. She is in pain all over the body. Every cell is paining. And then she throws up her hands and feet in despair. Her eyes pop out and she lies there as a huge corpse, 60 feet corpse. She dies. Mother Yashoda comes running and says, Rohini, where is Krishna? What happened? From where did this woman come? Oh, she came like an ordinary beautiful woman. How could this be? Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? And Rohini says, look at him. He's playing like a deer on a mountain. All over Putana. Putana looked like a mountain. Huge mountain of flesh. They take Krishna and then place him on a golden plank. The golden plank, because Krishna, no? And they take chilies, they take salt, and they're now doing the drishti sutarda. They are doing the removing of evil eyes. What are they saying? Indriyani Rishikesha Pranana Rayano Avatu Kridantam Patu Govindaha Shayanam Patu Madhavaha. The Lord is looking bewildered. My stupid mother, she is protecting me with my names. May Krishna protect you, may Govinda protect you, may Narayana protect you. Please remember, I have an episode which came across in my life, and that was when a great man called Bihari Baba in Jodhpur told me, Mother, tell your audience that more powerful than Krishna is Krishna Nama. That is why the women are protecting him with the Krishna Nama. Sri Rama wanted to know how the bridge was being built. Don't you remember that Upakatha? He went after working hours, 5 o'clock in the evening, when the sun was already setting. And he took a stone and threw it into the water. Hanumanji, his private secretary, standing behind him, clapped. He said, what a failure you are, Rama. What a failure. Rama looked back and said, when did you come? When you started walking towards the seashore. What did you watch? That you could not make the stone float. Why, Hanuman? Why is the stone not floating when I put it into the water? Because we have Ramanama and you don't have that Ramanama, my Lord. That is why. It is your name which is our Shakti. Our Shakti is the password. The Lord doesn't have his password. We have his password. I hope you understand. It is that which makes this beautiful woman who comes now to understand, Yashoda, understand, this is the Lord of the world. So many Krishna Leelas stand before me before we go into the climax called the Rasa Leela. One day, Krishna is eating mud. He has all his mischief, you know, up his sleeve. The most naughty child in the world. I really wonder how Mother Yashoda could manage him. I hope you know, Yashoda was 75 years when Krishna came as a child. 75 years. Old couple, waiting for the Lord, waiting for the Lord. Bahunam janmanamante jnanavanmam prabhadyate vasudeva sarvamiti samahatma sudurlabaha. That Yashoda has dressed him up beautifully and made him sit in the courtyard, and the Lord is busy eating mud. Who is the bodyguard? Balramji. The Lord is 1.5 years old, Balramji is 2.5 years old. Balramji is always scared of this bodyguard duty because he doesn't know what mischief the Lord will be up to. Every day it's dine dine navam navam. So he's watching the Lord. As he's watching the Lord gives him a disarming smile. Balramji says, don't smile like that. No, brother, I love you. I don't believe you. You're up to some mischief. Please tell me what you're going to do. Watch me. Watch me and then tell mother. With one hand he eats mud. Balramji says, don't eat, Krishna. It's bad for you, bad for the liver. What does he know? Kararavinde anapadaravindam mukharavinde vinivesayantam batasya patrasya puteshayanam balam mukundam manasasmarami. At the end of the deluge, when the world has come to be totally drowned in the water, that primordial child is sleeping on the Vatapatra with his toe in his mouth. He has the entire Brahmanda in his stomach. Balramji doesn't realize what is happening. You don't want me to eat mud? Go and tell mother that I'm eating mud. If you have two children, they'll constantly complain against each other. If you're a clever mother, don't listen to both of them. Because after 10 minutes, they'll be hugging each other. You understand? Now there goes, according to Krishna Karanamrita, lovely work on Krishna, exclusive work on Krishna, 300 odd verses. This great boy called Balrama goes to the mother and says, Ma, Ma, what happened? Krishna, what happened to Krishna? Krishna is eating mud. What did you say? Krishna is eating mud. Just now I gave him butter. Just now I gave him mithai. I gave him payasam and he's eating mud. All children do this. You give them the best breakfast, they go to the neighbor's house and have 4 idlis. Poor maternal ego is deflated. All children do that. They love to do that. Here is the Lord eating mud. Mother Yashoda comes running. The gods in heaven are watching because the courtyard is the center of attraction, cosmic attraction. She comes and holds him by the hand. Did you eat mud? Who told you? In court, either you say yes or no. No prevarication, no equivocation. We don't want any digression. Come to the point, yes or no. Who told you? Balrama, your elder brother, who has a musala in hand, he'll beat you up. Oh, you don't know about Balrama, Amma. Balrama is a felicitous liar. Every moment he reels off lies. Balramji says, I'm Adishesha. In my last birth, I was Lakshmana, followed you into the forest for 14 years, never told a lie, and you are blaspheming me now. Sacrilegious, my lord, sacrilegious. Ma, if you don't believe me, please look into my mouth and see. Acharya say it took 10 chapters for Arjuna to ask for the cosmic vision. Drashtum ichyami te rupam aishwaram purushottama manyase nitat shakyam maya drashtum iti prabho. And this woman gets it without asking. Don't you feel jealous of her? Open your mouth. Open your mouth. You know, when children love to eat, God knows what they eat. Everything available on the ground they're eating. And you say, open your mouth. Open. Open, she says. And the more she says open, the tighter he closes. Now he opened. What did Mother Yashoda see? Through that little 1-inch diameter mouth, what did she see? She saw all the 14 worlds. She saw the sun and the moon and the stars. She saw all the devatas. And then she saw within those 14 worlds a bhuloka, and within the bhuloka a gokula. In the gokula she saw a courtyard, in the courtyard she saw her house, and near the house she saw one more Krishna and Yashoda, and said, my God, what has happened? May that Krishna protect us. May that Krishna protect us. Every day there is some miracle performed. Something to bewilder you. Would you like to listen to this in Sanskrit? Krishnena ambagatena rantumaduna mrit bhakshita swechaya tatyam krishna kayeva maha musali mityamba mityamba pashyananam vyadehiti vidharite shishumukhe drishtva samastam jagat mata yastya jagama vismayapadam payatsana keshavaha. How did you like the shloka, my dear listeners? How did you like? This is the Sanskrit language. The beauty of the Sanskrit language that compresses so much into four lines and tells you a world of wisdom comes from it. Shriman Narayana in the Narayaniyam is given one more dimension. One day there is a knock at the door of Nand Baba. Bhattadri says when he opened the door, he saw Gargacharya. Welcome, sir. Welcome, Swami. Welcome. Nanda, you have a son. Black, jet black, beautiful child. Oh, really? Have you named him? We don't know how to do the naming ceremony, sir. We are rustics, we are villagers. Can I name him? Of course, Gargacharya, we would love you to name him. There comes Gargacharya, the old man, coming close to the cradle of Krishna and gives him one stare. The Lord gives him a second stare and says, you trying to name me? Oh, master. Try, give me a name. How can I give you a name, Swami? Vishwam Vishnur Vashatkaru Bhuta Bhavya Bhavat Prabhu Bhuta Krit Bhuta Vrit Bhavu Bhutatma Bhuta Bhavana. 100,000 names you have, master, and I am a non-descript, non-entity who has an ID card in every birth. Who am I to name you, my lord? The Lord said, give a short name. Imagine having a long name which is difficult to spell, more difficult to pronounce. Give a short name. Remember, Bhattadri is a grammarian. So he gives almost like a Panini Sutra. Krishidhatu nakarabhyam sattanandatmatam kilabhilapat jagat agakarshitvamba kathayatrishihi krishna namate vyatanot. Doesn't sound like a Naradiyam shlokam at all. He takes Krishidhatu and adds nakara. He is satchit ananda who removes all our sins. That is Krishna, my dear listeners, Krishna. so easy to pronounce, so easy to love, so easy to be loved by him, Krishna, Krishna. Those who love him will be saved, and those who hate him will be destroyed. That is the verdict given by Gargacharya at the naming ceremony function. My dear listeners, the Lord has several leelas to be performed. There is no time for all of them. I have to rush to the Rasa Leela. So I must tell you that the Lord Krishna plays on the flute. You know how the flute is made. The flute is an empty reed. This empty reed becomes a flute in the hands of the Lord. In the Venu Gita, the Lord is not seen by the gopis. They don't meet him. They see him from far in their mind's eye. But it is that flute which becomes the beckoning call for the Rasa Leela. My dear listeners, among all the Puranas, Srimad Bhagavata is the crest jewel, I told you. And in the Bhagavat Purana, the Dashama Skanda, 10th canto, is the crest jewel. In the Dashama Skanda, the Rasa Leela is the crest jewel. The crowning piece of the 10th canto is the Rasa Leela. Many people have misunderstood it. Many people have misunderstood and misinterpreted it. Swami Vivekananda said, if you're not prepared for the Rasa Leela, don't read it. You're likely to misread it. Remember, it's with the Jivatma and the Paramatma combination. It cannot be between man and woman. It is heinous, it is sacrilegious to be misinterpreting the Rasa Leela. A gentleman who belonged to India but lived in London wrote a book on Hinduism and said, oh, your Hindu god dancing with other men's wives on moonlit nights. I forgive him because he's dead. I don't want to give you the name of that man. He didn't understand. He didn't understand the Bhagavatam. He had not read the Bhagavatam. The first shloka of the Rasa Leela starts with the word Bhagavan. Beware of hasty misconclusion, Parikshit. I am talking of Bhagavan. And he is the one who came down from heaven in order to give the gopis, the jivatmas, the bliss of their life. Bhagavan pitaratri sharadotfulla mallika viksharantum manachakri yogamayam upashritaha. Bhagavan api, although he is Bhagavan, not like Thomas Hardy's President of the Immortals, indifferent to human tragedy. He's concerned with man. He came down into the world on Sharad Purnima day. On the Sharad Purnima day, if you go to Vrindavan, you'll go mad. Mad with ecstasy. The first time I went on the Sharad Purnima day into Bihari's temple, everything was white. The screens were white, the curtains were white, the flowers were white, the decoration was white. My Lord Bihari was in white silk and dazzling diamonds. So was my mother Radha. And I said, Krishna, 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 give me a song with one shloka and one verse in Hindi. This song came to me then in the presence of the Lord in the Sanctum Sanctorum. Bhagavan Pita Ratri Sharadotfulla mallika viksharantum manachakre yogamayam upashritah bhagavan pita ratri
sharadotfulla mallika
viksharantum
manachakre
yoga mayam upashritah nachehe kanha nachehe radha ke saath nachehe dharti nachehe gagan ye maharas ki raat ye to maharas ki raat nishamya geetam tadananga vardhanam vrajastriya krishna grihita manasa ajagmuranyunyam alakshitodyama sayatra kanto javalola kundala kanane hisi murli bajayi dodati dodati gopiyai choda hai ghar bar choda hai sansar maharas ki raat ye to maharas ki raat.
Imagine in the presence of the Lord, one shloka and one Gita of the Lord. That's how the gopis came running. One day, Cupid challenged Krishna. Cupid is Manmatha. Manmatha is one who causes Manthana of the mind. The Bhagavata is telling us that Cupid is asking Krishna, I want to beguile you. I want you to become a slave of Cupid. Krishna says, never, my dear. Challenge accepted. It'll be a moonlit night by the idyllic banks of the Yamuna when the breeze will blow the fragrance of jasmines and the most beautiful ladies will stand there. I will be Ishvara, Yogeshwara, Mahayogeshwara, Mahayogeshwareshwaraha. That is the night of the Rasalila. My master, so handsome, is now calling out to the gopis. He is going to call out to the gopis. I use the word Gmail before Gmail was introduced into the language of the internet. The email, the Gmail. Please remember, I said Gmail is God's mail to man. How did you come here? Because Krishna called you, my dear listeners. Krishna called you. We didn't call you. Krishna called you. That is how you come to the Bhagavatam. Janmantare bhavet punyam tada bhagavatam labhet. And how did he call?
Nishamya geetam tadananga vardhanam vrajastriya krishna grihita manasa.
The mind is the seat of passion. Are you listening? The mind is the seat of passion. Krishna took away the mind. Matrainam kamangal matrailor embavai. May our kama become prema. The greatness of the gopis is the object of their love was the subject of salvation, my dear listeners. Remember that. The object of their love was the subject of salvation. For us, there are two different things. What we love and what we have for moksha are two different things. For them, it was one and the same. And that's why Krishna grihita manasaha. And how did they come? When you go for a wedding, even Kolu, even for Navratri Kolu, you are only watching the lady of the house. My God, what jewelry she is wearing. How many cars she has in the portico. Suddenly they have grown rich. All this you are talking while you are receiving manjal kumkumam. No? All the time we are talking about each other. But when you come to the katha and if you are talking to each other, it means Amma's katha is not good. When you enter Venkateswara's temple, you don't remember anything. Govinda, Govinda, Govinda. No before, no after. You don't even remember the companion who has come with you because you only one companion and that is Govinda. Please remember that.